गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इन दैट पार्ट ए एंड बी ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8.3। होप यू ऑल हैव गॉन थ्रू द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज। इफ नॉट, प्लीज गो थ्रू इट वंस सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस एक्सरसाइज। स्टूडेंट्स, एवरी टाइम दे हैव गिवन यू द क्वेश्चन, you will see that question one thing, that is if it is given compounded annually or compounded half yearly, because in introductory part I have given you that if it is annually then you have to take for solving amount for annually this one and for half yearly this formula. So let us start question number 1 in that first part. Says, first of all, question number 1 says calculate the amount A, that is A, and compound interest, that is CI, on first part rupees 8200 for 3 years at 12.5% per annum means 1 year, and they have told us it is compounded annually. So whenever the word comes compounded annually, you will take that formula which I have given you. The formula is A is equal to, amount is equal to principal 1 plus R divided by 100 into T. T can be capital also or small also, whatever you want to write. So what is the principal here? Principal is 10,800. How much year? That is T. T is 3 years, and rate of percentage is 12.5, which is in mixed fraction. So I will multiply 12 2s are 24 plus 1 25 by 2 percentage. Now putting this in this formula, we will get amount. So we will write, therefore amount is equal to principal, that is 10,800, 1 plus R is 25. It is divided by 2, so divided by 2 I will write here and multiply it by 100. So R divided by 2, denominator of denominator will multiply, so denominator of this and the denominator this will be multiply, and time period is of 3 years. Here you can see clearly 25 ones are and 25 fours are, so it will become 10,800 into 1 plus 1 upon 2 fours are 8. Taking LCM, we will get 10,800 into 8 ones are 8 plus 1 divided by 8, which will be 10,800 into 9 by 8. And every time it is 3 raised to 3. Sorry, 9 by 8 raised to 3. So this I can write like this, 10,800, it is cube, so we will write multiply by 10 divided by 8, multiply by 10 divided by 8, multiply by 10 divided by 8, because it is 3 times. Solving for 8 and this, we will get 1,350. 8 ones are and 8 1,350s are. 2 fours are and 2, if I calculate, I will get 675. So finally I will get 675 multiply by 9 multiply by 9 multiply by 9 whole divided by 8 fours are 32. So when you multiply this above, that you know from standard 4 and 5, when you will multiply this amount, you will get 492,075 divided by, it is 32. Now on dividing these two terms, which I know, you know the calculation. So it will be rupees 15,000 377.34 rupees. Students, this calculation, multiplication and division, I want you all to solve, because it is explained in 4th and 5th standard. So our amount is, therefore amount is 15,377.34. They want us to find amount and compound interest. So amount we have got. So I will write, therefore compound interest is equal to, what is the amount? Principal minus principal. Amount is 15,377.34 minus principal was 10,800. So when I will solve, I will get compound interest is equal to rupees 4,577.34. When you will solve, when you will subtract this amount from this, you will get 4,577.34. Now moving to part B, let me first write it down. Part B says, find compound interest on rupees 18,000 for 2.5 years at 10% per annum compounded annually. Students, whenever they have given you compounded annually, you will take the formula A is equal to P 1 plus R divided by 100 multiplied by T. But whenever they have given you compounded annually and T they have given you in mixed fraction, so what you will do? You will first calculate amount for 2 years and then find the simple interest. Mark my word, simple interest of half year, and add that simple interest and amount, you will get the total amount. Again, when they have given you compounded annually and time period they have given you in mixed fraction, that is 2.5 years, then first you are supposed to find the amount for 2 years and half year's simple interest you are supposed to find. Whatever the simple interest from half years you will get, that amount plus amount which you got from 2 years will be your total amount. So let us begin. If you have not understood, pay attention here. Principal year it is rupees 18,000. Rate of interest is equal to 10%. And T is equal to, let me first take for 2 years. So my amount is equal to P multiply by 1 plus R divided by 100 into T. P is equal to 18,000 multiply by 1 plus R is equal to 10 divided by 100 raised to power 2. 1010 will cancel out. So my amount will be 18,000 into, then I will take LCM. LCM is 10. So I will get 10 plus 1, 11 whole raised to power 2. Therefore, amount is equal to 18,000 into bracket 11 by 10 raised to power 2. This 11 by 2 I will write like this: 18,000 into 11 by 10 into 11 by 10, because it is 2 times. So 0, 0 from here and 2 zeros from here will cancel out. So remaining amount will be 180 multiply by 11 multiply by 11. Now you will get 180 into 11, 11 is 121. So 180, when you multiply 180 with 121, your amount you will get is 21,780 rupees. This is the amount which you got from 2 years, but we want amount for 2.5 years. So remaining half year you will calculate simple interest. Now for simple interest, but for solving simple interest, students, please pay attention. You can't take principal as 18,000. because you want to find the simple interest on the remaining half year, so your amount will become principal. So a formula for simple interest is SI is equal to P into R into T divided by 100. So principal year they have given is 21,780 multiply by R is 10 multiply by T. T is half. Half I can write 1 and whole divide by 2. This will become, this denominator will come down and multiply with 100. Now two zeros from 100, one zero from 10 and one zero from 21,780 will cancel out. So I will get SI is equal to 2178 multiply by 1 all divide by 2. I can write 2178 only. On dividing it further, 21s are 2, 20s are 0, 28s are 16 and 129s are 18. I will get simple interest is equal to 1089. Now this amount plus simple interest will give me total amount. So I will write like this. Therefore, total amount is equal to 21,780 plus 1,089, and that if you calculate 21,780 plus 1,089, you will get 22,869. Okay, this will be our total amount. So amount which we wanted, it is here. Now they have told compound interest also, so I will write therefore compound interest is equal to amount, that is total amount, minus principal. What is total amount? 22,869 minus interest is 18,000. So I will get, when I will calculate this, I will get the interest is as 4,869. It is clearly visible. 2000 and 2869 will give me 4,869. Therefore, compound interest is equal to rupees 4,869. So this was two parts, part A and part B. We will meet with the remaining part in new video. Till then, take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe. If you have not understood, please go through it 2-3 times so that you can understand properly. Bye bye.